Sometimes when you win, you lose.
And welcome to this Warhammer 40,000 battle report. Today we're going to be playing 2,000 points of Imperial Guard versus Dark Angels. Miles has come back for a second game. Well, I say come back, we do live in the same house. But yeah, we're looking to get some revenge for the last time we played on this channel, Blood Angels versus Dark Angels. One quick thing to note before we just start describing this terrain is when we played that game, my army was completely painted, but not really much of Miles's was. He's done his best to get some painted, but I'm afraid it's going to be the case that not much is painted. So if you're one of those people who can't stand grey models, probably not best, not the best idea to watch this battle report, because there's going to be a lot of it. But I thought to myself, you know, is it better to have no battle report or a battle report of grey models? And I deemed people would just prefer to have a battle report. The new guard codex is just around the corner, so hopefully this match is going to be a really nice send-off to the old guard codex. So, just going to describe this terrain. We've rolled off. We're going to be playing the relic. And there is the relic there, right in the centre of the board. In terms of terrain, we've got this building and ruins around it. And clearly this is a shell or something has hit this and exposed this important relic in the middle. And both sides want it. We've got some hills here. This is the guard line where they're going to be deploying at some woodland. Then over on this side, we've got some more woodland and some more hills. So really, the terrain here is quite bleak and open. You know, there's not as much terrain as perhaps you would like, but the main thing to remember is most of the fighting is going to be going around in this area, and this is definitely going to be dominated by all these ruins. So we've rolled off, and the Dark Angels who will be deploying here should have first turn. We'll get to seize the initiative and that shenanigans in a minute. So that's the scenario for you guys. I'll get back to you in a second with the two forces. Hopefully today will be a good game. Right, so this is the 2,000 points of Imperial Guard I'm going to be bringing. Subscribers of my channel should be very, very familiar with this list, so I'm going to run through it very quickly. Company Command Squad with a Bolt Pistol, Plasma Gun, two Sniper Rifles, Volkscaster, Master of Ordnance, Commissar Yarrick. Over to Elites, 10 Stormtroopers, Melter Gun and a Plasma Gun in there, in a Chimera. Troop Choice 1, a Platoon. We've got in the Command Squad a Bolt Pistol, Heavy Flamer, two Regular Flamers and a Volkscaster. Then in the two Infantry Squads, a Melter, a Grenade Launcher, and a Volkscaster. Second troop choice, in the Command Squad we have a Bolt Pistol, Grenade Launcher. In the two Infantry Squads we have a Flamer and a Melter. Heavy Weapons Teams, here we have three Autocannons, three Las Cannons. Heavy Support, a Lehman Russ, Battle Cannon, no sponsons, but we have camo netting, a Lehman Russ Demolisher. We've got a hole mounted las cannon, we've got plasma sponsons, and we have camo netting, a basilisk camo netting. Then fast attack, two Vendetta gunships, and last of all, over here on the map, we have an Aegis defense line with a quad gun. So as I said, hopefully everyone's familiar with that list. Used it before in battle reports. Let's move on to Miles and his Dark Angels.
This is my 2,000 point Dark Angels Space Marine Army. First of all, we have two Deathwing Tactical Squads, Deathwing Terminator Squads, sorry. Both of them are standard with only minor upgrades to them, one with a cyclone missile launcher and one with a assault cannon. Next off we have two tactical marine squads, identical, they both come with rhinos and they both have plasma cannons and plasma gun upgrades. We have a assault marine squad with 10 men in it and one plasma gun, plasma pistol, sorry. Behind that we have a three-man Black Knight squad, no upgrades as you go. To the left of that we have a land speeder, just nothing special to it, just standard land speeder. With a to the right of that we have a Devastator squad with four missile launchers, one of which, the guy with the pistol at the back, has a flat missile upgrade. With a Venerable Dreadnought with twin las cannons on the sides, and a Predator Annihilator pattern, so all with las cannons, and a Vengeance with heavy bolter instead of assault cannon.
And I guess last of all, your Warlord.
My Warlord, very tooled up, company master with jetpack, artifice armour, plasma pistol and Mesa Redemption, a nasty little weapon indeed.
So, us Miles' Dark Angels army, you probably recognise the bulk of it from the last battle report we did. A few extras in there, should be quite a fun list. Like I say, today should be a good send-off for the Guard. We've played each other many times, so let's hope it's an enjoyable game. Right, so deployment is just about done. Guard have had to be a little bit creative here. We've put the Demolisher here in the woods, and he's looking to absolutely obliterate the Knights when they push up so they don't bring in that homing beacon for the Terminators. Got a big cluster of infantry there to support him. Command squad in the back, heavy weapons teams, another big swarm of infantry on the other flank. Then some command squads at the back with Yarrick embedded in that squad. Then right on the back line are two big ordnance weapons with the long range. Over for the Dark Angels, on this side of the line he's gone for his Devastator squad with the missile launchers. Then his Blacklights, who obviously with that locator beacon on them, or homing beacon, they're going to look to bring in the Terminators without scattering, which can be pretty nasty. Then the Predator Annihilator, Landspeeder Vengeance. Then over here it looks like this force is going to be heading in and claiming the relic here. We've got the Venerable Dreadnought, his Warlord, the Assault Marines, and then the two Tacks in the Rhinos. So we're just about ready to start now. I've got a few last little things to do. First of all, can I seize the initiative on a 6-up? Come on. I don't. And then the next thing is night flying in effect. Yeah, night flying is in effect. You can see that's a 6. So all that's really left is scout moves, and then we're just about ready to start. Right, so in reserve for the Imperial Guard, we have the two Vendettas and the Stormtroopers in the Chimera. Right, so in reserve for the Dark Angels, all we have is the two Terminator squads and a Land Speeder. One last thing we almost forgot to mention, for Warlord traits, Yarrick is my Warlord. I rolled off on strategic traits, hoping to get that 4, you know, for rerolling reserves. And instead I got a 1, which means that my troops have the stealth special rule when they're in ruins, and have move through cover when in ruins. Which on the face of it sounds pretty useless, but when you look at the area the relic in, it's a very ruined area, so maybe that will come into play later on. Miles has also rolled for his Warlord traits, and the Dark Angels got
a 1, which is not really that amazing, but it does give my Warlord the chance to re-roll his run move, so he could get another 6 inches.
Okay. And I believe you've also taken your scout moves. So, as I predicted, the Dark Knights have pushed up and are ready for the battle cannon to destroy them. So we're about ready to start. We'll get back to you after movement on Dark Angels turn 1. movement for the Dark Angels on turn one. The Black Knights have been crafty and they've driven through this small doorway and they're now arrayed in here. They're going to get some ridiculous cover saves and fire down on the line. Devastators, they've stayed put, looking to get some shots off. The Predator has swiveled a little bit. Obviously, you're looking to fire down here. Loud Speed of Vengeance has jumped up here. It wasn't actually possible for us to put him where he should be, but he's actually a little bit further back. He's more sort of on the lip. So we've agreed that he's not going to be able to shoot at me, but I'm not going to be able to shoot at him. So it's like we can't see him because he's sort of just round about this area. Then over here, the Dreadnought has moved up along with the Assault Marines. And the two Rhinos have also pushed up, looking to flank the objective. So that's about it for movement from the Dark Angels. But let's see what happens with Dark Angel shooting on turn one. Shooting from the Dark Angels on turn one. It's been, what with night fighting and the distances we're fighting out, it's been pretty ineffectual. The Rhino fired across and had a two up cover save because we have shrouded because of night fighting, we have a defense line, so we're two up. These guys just stayed put, most of them out of range. The Black Knights here, we almost forgot about them, they're so hidden away, fired into the side armour of the Demolisher and failed to do anything. The Predator and the Devastators fired across. The Devastators failed to do anything to the front armour, strength 8 against armour 14. You know, he only rolled quite badly. And then the Predator actually managed to glance him, but he has a 3-up cover save because shrouded in a wood. So what with night fighting, the whole guard line is completely intact. We're going to move on to guard, turn one. But remember, the Dark Angel is going to have night fighting as well. So I'm guessing there's going to be some pretty ineffectual shooting from both sides on turn one. Let's see what the guard can do on turn one. So, in terms of shooting, and I think movement for the guard, obviously they're just going to sit and shoot, so there was no real shooting here. I mean, no real movement here even. In terms of shooting, all of this is, you know, a 4-up save because of the ruins, and a lot of it is shrouded because of night fighting, giving a 2-up cover save. So, just in summary, I barked out some orders, making him re-roll cover saves. But even with the re-rolling, you know, he had a 2-up cover save. So from fire from the auto cannons, the quad gun, I think the las cannons as well, we only managed to shave off one hull point. So that was pretty ineffective because that 2-up save. The best shooting we had was these guys were inside 12, so they only had a 4-up cover save. And fire from the Humble las cannons, las guns, sorry, fire from the Humble las guns killed all three Black Knights. Shells were also fired across from here. We were within 36, so we could still see. And he had even more 2-up cover saves, which he made a whole load of. The barrage weapon, however, he would not have got the cover save off that, because it's taken as though it's coming from the centre. So one Assault Marine did die. We've also took, the building took some hits, and it is now down to 2 structure points, so if that goes down, that's all going to collapse. It also said that units inside should have taken some hits, but seeing as he's floating over it, we deem that he wouldn't take any. But the building could collapse. And then last of all, the Demolisher fired across its plasma cannons, and he's still got a nice cover save, but we killed one of the Devastators. So pretty ineffective shooting from both sides there. The night fighting just grinding crazy cover saves. But first turn does give first blood to the Imperial Guard, so there's going to be no night fighting in the next turn. So let's see what happens in Dark Angels turn two. Thank you. So we're now into Dark Angel's turn two, and from reserve, the Terminators have teleported in here. Obviously, pretty menacing for the guard line to have Terminators appear so close. Rhinos, this convoy has sort of moved around, and the back squad of Tacticals have jumped out. Dreadnought has shuffled up and is now just sitting behind those ruins. And the Assault Squad have boosted up on top of the building. And the Land Speeder has zoomed on. Last of all, these squads have just sat here looking to shoot. So we're going to move in to shooting for the Dark Angels on turn two. So, shooting for the Dark Angels, it's been a tiny bit more effective. The first Imperial Guard models have gone down, but overall it's been pretty poor shooting, really. These guys, Deathwing Assault, got to twin-link all their shots, fired into this squad, caused a whole load of wounds, and it was actually going to the company commander. I then lookout-sired a whole load, and then made a whole load of 4-ups from this cover. They also have a 4-up armor save, so didn't really matter. But yeah, two guys with the sniper rifles went down there. Over here, these guys went flat out, so pushing up. A tactical squad that disembark managed to crack off a few rounds its heavy weapon team, but cover saves were made. Dreadnought fired down and failed to damage this guy. And then up on the top, the assault marines just sat where they were. The Vengeance fired down its big, you know, plasma pie plate, you know, big chance of wiping this squad, scattered across, caused a few wounds, and these guys made their cover. Except for one guy who went down. So this squad has lost one guy, and this squad has lost two. And then over here, missile launchers and the Predator Annihilator all fired at the tank, but as you can see, it's been completely untouched. So, summary of all their shooting, one guardsman and two veterans in the command squad. So pretty ineffective there. However, this game is all going to be about closing the distance and getting in tight for the Dark Angels. So, you know, let's see what happens on Imperial Guard turn two. So Imperial Guard turn two, bit of movement now. This infantry squad has wrapped around and is obviously going to look at to fire on these Terminators. Do not underestimate the Lascat guns. They have killed Terminators before. Over to reserves. One Vendetta has come screaming onto the field. We couldn't actually place his base right. He's more about there. But, you know, he's flown on from the back line. And obviously bearing down on some targets. The other Vendetta has also flown on. It's pretty obvious the targets he's eyeing up. And then last of all, the Stormtroopers have outflanked and got out of their Chimera. And they're going to be mauling this tactical squad, hopefully. So, targets popping up all over the place for the Dark Angels. This is an important turn of shooting. Let's see what the Imperial Guard can do on shooting for them on turn two. What's happened is the company commander has issued front rank fire, second rank fire on these guys. We fired the pistols, we fired the melter gun, we fired the grenade launcher. And now we're going to see if las cannons can kill any of these Terminators. We have this many shots, so we're just going to roll those up and see what happens. So I've just rolled those up. This is how many hits we got. This is how many misses. So obviously that's statistically worse. However, let's see what these hits can do. So we need fives. So removing all the fives and sixes, looking pretty good. That is quite a few. So we got that many fives and sixes. So, Miles, can you make all of these 2-ups? So, two Terminators just died to fire from these squads. So, I think that just goes to show you definitely shouldn't underestimate las guns. They can really be quite effective on the right occasion.
A hot torch has basically burnt through armor that can stand a nuclear reaction. So, yeah.
So, a summary of shooting for the Imperial Guard on turn two, and it's been some, well, devastating shooting, really. This squad fired across, killed some Terminators. Company commander also fired and killed some more Terminators, so that squad is down to 2 now. Pretty nasty there. Las cannons, Bring It Down was issued. It blew up. Squad inside took some casualties. And then the Lehman Russ fired across, killed some more. They're down to 2. Over here, Stormtroopers have disembarked, fired and destroyed that tactical squad completely. They're now gone. Yarrick with the quad gun fired up and wrecked the land speeder Vengeance. Basilisk lobbed a shell over and killed a whole load of Marines up there, so that squad is pretty much down. The disappointing thing was this Vendetta fired across and failed to do anything to the Predator, and this Vendetta fired across and failed to do anything to... Well, actually, no, it took a single hull point off that Dreadnought, so that's pretty bad. And then the Demolisher fired its 2 Plasmas across, killed some more Devastators. They've broken morale and they've fallen back, but they will regroup. So that was very, very effective shooting from the Guard there. It's looking very much in their favour, yet still to come on for the Dark Angels are some more Terminators. So it's far from over yet. Game is definitely not done yet, but that is some very damaging shooting from the Imperial Guard. No assaults for them this turn, so we're going to jump straight in to movement for the Dark Angels on turn 3. So, Dark Angels reserves on turn 3. The other Terminator squad has deep striked here. To show you where that is. Here is the massed ranks of the Guardsmen. Here's where he's gone. It's quite risky though. There's a table edge there. There's stuff here. There's a Basilisk here. So, will he stay or will he scatter? Let's see what happens. And he has direct hitted. So, now the Guard have to deal with Terminators right behind their line and Terminators here. We'll get back to you after the rest of the movement for Dark Angels on turn 3. So, a summary for movement for the Dark Angels on turn 3. They're on the move. These guys have deep striked behind our lines. That's going to cause a lot of problems for the Guard. These guys have pushed up. I think it's clear what they're going to take out. These guys, they're basically reduced to combat ineffectiveness, but they've moved forward, and I think they're going to try and go toe-to-toe with this Guard squad and be a bit of an annoyance. Company Master... He's boosted down from over here, and he looks like he's bearing down on these squads. So, you know, let's go with he's going to cause trouble. And then over here, the Devastators regrouped because they're Space Marines, so obviously they automatically did, and they've moved back up. They're only about to snap fire, but they're still hanging in there. And then there's the Predator, which is sat still, going to fire some more shots. And then last of the movement, I should also add that the Land Speeder failed to come in. He's been a bit crafty here. This Rhino has reversed and is blocking these Stormtroopers from heading to the Relic to secure it. Obviously, they're elites, not troops, but they can still, you know, deny it to the Dark Angels. However, he's blocked me off, meaning I'm either going to have to go around him or try and explode and then take him out. Because that's an empty Rhino, so it's effectively useless, but he's blocked me off there. And then the Dreadnought has turned around. He can only snap fire this round, due to him being shaken, or was it stunned? I think it was stunned.
Stunned.
He got his snap fire anyway, but he is looking to take out the Chimera. So that's it really for movement from the Dark Angels on turn 3. Let's see what their shooting can do. So the start of shooting for the Dark Angels, the first thing they did was crack missiles into the side of him. He hit with one round. He got a 6, so he penned. So it was looking like the Russ was going down. He has got camo netting though, so he has stealth in the open. 6 up cover save. There was my save. So
jammy, very jammy.
Yeah, very lucky there from the Guard. Okay, we're going to move on and do the rest of Dark Angel shooting, and we'll get back to you with a summary of that. But ridiculous, ridiculous rolling from the Guard there. So quite a mixed round of shooting for the Dark Angels in turn 3. There's been some effective stuff and some not so effective stuff. This Terminator squad fired across and completely wiped this command squad that was here with the Flamers. As you saw, these guys fired across and he made a 6 up cover save, which was quite ridiculous. These guys, one of them threw a grenade and killed, I think, 4 guys, so that was pretty good. And then a pistol fired across. Obviously, they're going to assault next round. Over here, the plasma pistol wielding sergeant killed himself. Then they chucked a grenade across. It scattered, wounded one of the heavy weapons teams. And I think one of the other guardsmen died. And over here, slap firing, the devastators did nothing. This guy fired across and rolled double ones to pen against armor 14 here. So nothing happened there. And then over here, the really, really ridiculous stuff happened. This guy was penned last round. He was stunned, so could only fire a snapshot. He rolled a 6 to hit the Chimera. He rolled to pen, rolled a 6, so it exploded. He rolled to see how far the explosion went, and he rolled a 6. So that was 4 sixes in a row. 6 to hit, 6 to pen, 6 to explode, and then 6 for distance. So 3 or 4 stormtroopers have died as well. That was just ridiculous. 4 sixes in a row. What can you do? But that's about it then. There will be some assaulting this turn though. So we'll get back to you with the results of those assaults. So assaults to the Dark Angels in turn 3. These guys have pushed up and got into contact with the Russ. These guys have vaulted over, survived some Overwatch hits, and are in contact here. These guys made actually, I think, quite a lot of Overwatch saves. You know, very good Overwatching from the Laz guns, but they've also made it in. So we have this assault, we have this assault, we have this assault to finish. And then after those have been resolved, we'll get back. So Dark Angels turn 3 is now over. Obviously, the two Power Fists here penned and exploded the Russ. That was expected. What wasn't expected was for him to roll a 6 for his explosion, come out, wipe about half of that squad, and then kill a few guys there. That was pretty ridiculous. Over here, these guys also... they actually failed to kill anyone, and the guard failed to kill anyone back. It was just this exploding killed a whole load of them. And then over here, I issued a challenge with one of my sergeants. He accepted with his company master, who he killed. And then the assault marine killed one other guy. So the guard lost 2 men there. And then we lost the combat, but we made morale. So we're sticking around. So the fight there is going to continue. So that's it for Dark Angels turn 3. Which means we're about to go into Imperial Guard turn 3. Let's see what the guard can do. Movement for the Imperial Guard on turn 3. This Russ has twisted round, looking to take out these guys. Vendetta continues bearing down on that tank. This Vendetta also continues. The stormtroopers over here, they've all shuffled into the crater. And then, final bit of movement over here. This command squad has backed to the wall with Yarrick, looking to fight off the threat from these Terminators. So let's see what shooting can do for the guard on turn. So shooting for the Imperial Guard on turn 3, Yarrick flipped the autocannon around. The heavy weapon squads with the autocannons and the last cannons turn around. Brought a load of fire there, killed a few Terminators. The big pie plate, strength 10 AP2, hit there, hit all of them, hit all 5, that was the first thing to shoot at them, and then rolled 3 ones, so he didn't even wound, and then he made 2 5 up invulnerable saves. That was ridiculous there, but they are down to 2 guys. Over here, the plasma fired across and killed another Terminator, so there are 3 Terminators currently sitting behind our line, still a threat, but hopefully we can deal with them. These 2 squads obviously couldn't fire because they're tied up in combat. Over here, stormtroopers decided to blow up the Rhino, which had a huge explosion and killed 2 more of them, so they're only down to half their numbers now. The Vendetta fired down and killed the Venerable Dreadnought. Had to re-roll his penetration, but re-rolled it and blew him up a second time, so he is gone. Then down here, the Basilisk actually lobbed a shell over and quite badly damaged this, but then fire from the Vendetta finished him off. So the only Dark Angels unit that is actually surviving on this half of the table is these two Devastators. And then over here, there are these two Assault Marines and the Company Master, along with his Assault Marine, and then three Terminators. So not much Dark Angel stuff left on the board, but what is left is certainly capable of causing some serious issues. So it's far from over yet. The Land Speeder also is going to come on this turn, because it's turn four. So we're going to move in to Dark Angel's turn four. Oh wait, no, there's Assaults, sorry. We're going to resolve these Assaults, and that'll be Dark Angel's turn. Just something to note in the Imperial Guard Assault phase, I always like to show any ridiculous rolls. These guys struck first, missed with both their attacks. So the guard went to hit back, they had a whole load of attacks, needing force to hit. These are all two hits. All of that missed. So just ridiculous rolling there. Anyway, we'll see you with the summary of the assault phase. So the results of those combats, the two hits you saw there failed to do anything, so nothing happened there, no one died for the second turn in a row, so that's just tied up, nothing happening. Over here, I issued another challenge with my sergeant. He accepted and managed to hack down the sergeant, but then the last Salt Marine died from rusty bayonets to the neck. So, you know, that was also tied. So both of these two combats are going to continue. We're successfully tar-pitting up these units, but we're going to move now into Dark Angels, turn four. So, movement for the Dark Angels on turn four. This guy has come automatically. He's just moving down, looking to kill the Stormtroopers, who are going to probably get a Linebreaker, so that's probably a good decision there. The Devastator's there. He's actually moved them across. And I think what he's planning on doing is trying to, you know, deny me the relic. But, I mean, personally, I would have stood and shot. But, you know, it's a ballsy move from the Dark Angels, so I like it. And then, last of all, over here, obviously these two squads are still tied up. Terminators look like they're moving in for Yarrick. Okay, so that's about it for movement. Let's see what happens in Dark Angel shooting on turn four. So, a summary of Dark Angel shooting. That squad snap-fired across and did nothing. This guy fired his heavy bolter and killed one Stormtrooper. And then over here, both of the Terminators fired at Yarrick's squad and almost wiped his Armageddon Steel Legion bodyguard. That's about it. So we're going to get into the assault phase now. So assaults for the Dark Angels. This guy declared an assault. Yarrick overwatched and so did his buddy. And he died from overwatch. So now these guys are looking to assault Yarrick. It needs to be an epic charge. Let's see if they get in. And on a 4 and a 3 to a 7, they are in. So that's going to be an epic combat coming up at the end of turn four. So, results from that combat. Again, absolutely nothing happened here. This is just a complete tar pit for both of us, nothing going on here. We'll move around over here. And this was actually, he killed two guardsmen, and we hit back and took a wound off him. So, and then we made our morale, so that combat continues. Both of these combats going on for ages. And then over here, as you can see, Commissar Yarrick whirled round and in a load of blood and gore crushed and hacked to death two Terminators. Here, he took a wound in the process, but he's sticking around. So what I'm going to do now is, because there's really not that much Dark Angel stuff left, there's these two guys, there's this guy, there's the Land Speeder in that corner, and two Devastators. There's not really that much left on the board. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go around and just show you what the battlefield is looking like. Then we're going to get into Imperial Guard turn four. movement from the Imperial Guard on turn 4. Yarrick has moved off. He hasn't got much targets to shoot at. It's a risky move challenging that guy to a single combat, but I'm going to go for it. I fancy it. It's going to be entertaining if nothing else. Something strange has happened here. Heavy weapons teams never move. These guys jumped over the barricade and are moving off to claim the relic. It's been a bit of a weird one. The relic's just been sort of ignored by everyone, and then the troops that have gone near it have just been wiped. But these guys fancy it. This guy has moved out of cover. The Vendetta screamed on to go take out those guys, the only real targets he has, but he's there to finish up the job should the Vendetta fail. Then over here, the Stormtroopers have moved up. They're going to get me Linebreaker, hopefully, and then the last Vendetta is going to finish off him. So let's see what Imperial Guard shooting can do on turn 4. Just not that many targets to shoot at now, but it's an interesting game. The game is definitely in the balance. This is not, although most of the Dark Angels are dead, this is not settled by a long way. So let's see what happens on Imperial Guard shooting. So Imperial Guard shooting on turn 4. Vendetta fired in and penetrated him, but only rolled a 3. So he's taken some damage, and he's down to one hull point, but he's still in the game. Stormtroopers ran in here. They're going to get me Linebreaker, hopefully. Heavy weapons teams ran. Oh, this is so surreal for me. Heavy weapons teams never move or run, and yet they're coming out, and they're going to seize that relic for me, hopefully. And then over here, Vendetta fired down, killed another Devastator, and then to finish him off, the Lehman Ross Demolisher also fired across and killed him. So the only thing left for the Dark Angels from the whole of this side of the board is this damaged Land Speeder. And then over here, there is some combats to be resolved. So we'll get back to you after that. Right, so a summary of Imperial Guard combat. Over here, nothing happened. This combat is ridiculous. It's been going on for turns and turns, and not a single person has died. But this could be significant, considering the fact that these two, this guy, and the Land Speeder in the corner, are the only things left on the board for the Dark Angels. So if these guys just hang in there and don't die, they could be important, because they mean the Dark Angels won't get tabled. So now there is this combat to do. So this is important. It's Warlord against Warlord, victory point at stake, and also one of the few Dark Angels things left on the board. So we're going to see what happens here. So he is striking first at a high initiative. So the company master goes, and he hits 3 times, needing
2s.
He's so that was strength 7 on T4. So only 1 wound, and then he has to re-roll that because of Yarrick's rule. He's got a force field protecting him. So that does wound. So Yarrick there takes a wound. He also has to take a blind check, which he fails. So he is now at weapon skill 1, but he needs 5s to hit then. So 2 hits there. Sorry, it's really difficult to film and roll at the same time. I'll try and be better at this. So then he needs, he gets the reroll. So another hit. So he gets 3 hits there. And then he needs 2s to wound, strength 6, AP 2. So 2 in there, which means 2 iron halo saves. If he fails both, he's dead. Oh, and he made both. Unbelievable. So this combat is going to continue because Yarrick's fearless. And this means that we're going to go into Dark Angels turn 5. So, very straightforward, Dark Angels movement. The damaged Land Speeder has just moved across, clearly looking to fire down here at these guys going for this. That's about it. So we'll get back to you after that shoot. So, combat results for the Dark Angels on turn 5. The Imperial Guard finally with bayonets and lasgun butts, smacked to death two Space Marines. So they're gone. These guys consolidated and just sitting here. And then over here, Yarrick went down to two extra wounds before he could use his, you know, strength power of claw. He would have died if he didn't make those four up Invon saves, though, his company master. So quite unlucky there from Yarrick, really. But then the fact he had taken two wounds affected the overall combat. Because remember, they were still tied to this big combat they'd been going here for ages. They failed, and he has a higher initiative, so he outran that squad. Yarrick can still get up, however, and that ended in his turn. So now he's going to have to survive a whole torrent of fire, and Yarrick might get up. So we're going to move into Imperial Guard turn 5. Does Yarrick get up? This is important because it will give me the IM Slay the Warlord. No. Yarrick died.
Yeah.
Couldn't make a free up. Oh well. Anyway, we're going to make some movement now, and we'll get back to you after Imperial Guard moves. So, movement for the Imperial Guard. Obviously, Yarrick failed to get up. The commander, Captain, has come over here and claimed the quad gun, so he can fire across it in. These guys are obviously going to look to fire across, and this infantry squad has moved off to fire it in. Vendettas have both gone into hover mode and are looking to fire at him. And the Lehman Russ Demolisher can obviously fire some stuff at him. Although that could scatter, so we'll see what happens there. Over here, heavy weapons teams. Let's say, hilarious that they're on the move. They're in a hair's breadth away from claiming that objective. And finally, over here, these stormtroopers have moved into the woods and are going to take out that land speeder, hopefully. So, lots of shooting to do. We'll get back to you with the results of shooting. Right, so we're midway through shooting for the Imperial Guard on turn 5. The Melter and the Plasma in the Stormtrooper squad fired across and killed the Landspeeder. And then over here, heavy weapon teams have run and they're now sitting on the relic. So it looks like we've secured that. So the only thing left for the Dark Angels on the board is the Company Master. So it doesn't really look good for him with the amount of firepower around. So let's roll this live. First of all, the two Vendettas are going to shoot at him. So they need fours. So two misses, but twin linked. So they all hit. Then they need twos. Oh, terrible. Three ones in there. But, still, he has to make three 4-up invulnerable saves for his Iron Halo, and if he fails one, I was going to make that a bit more epic by describing it, but he's went on it. But yeah, he is now dead, and as I was about to say, that is the last Dark Angels player on model on the board. So that is an Imperial Guard win. Well played, Miles. Shake my hand on camera. Well done, mate. So that's probably the last time I'll play with this Imperial Guard army until the new codex is out. Thanks a lot for watching. We're now going to have a tally up of victory points and we'll get back to you in a second. So we just did a quick count up, and the guard hold the relic, they have Linebreaker, they slew the Warlord, and they got First Blood, so six, all of them that are available to them, and the Dark Angels slayed the Warlord. So it's a 6-1 win, Actually, the Dark Angels were tabled, so that's just an auto win. But if you're doing current kill points, or victory points even, then that would have been a 6-1 win. I don't think that... It was a bit closer than that scoreline reflects. I think Miles played quite well today.